Hello friends, welcome to our third video. Let's see the question. Consider the following statements with respect to network security. Message confidentiality means that the sender and the receiver expect privacy. Message integrity means that the data must arrive at the receiver exactly as they were sent. Message authentication means the receiver is ensured that the message is coming from the intended sender. Now let's see the genuineness of each of the options. Statement 1 is correct. Confidentiality is the property that the original plaintext message cannot be determined by an attacker who intercepts the ciphertext encryption of the original plaintext message. Statement 2 is also correct. Message integrity means that a message has not been tampered with or altered. To ensure message integrity, hash functions are used. Statement 3 is also correct. Message authenticity is a property that ensures that the message has not been modified while in transit and receiving party can verify the source of the message. Moving on to our next question, consider the following statements. Three statements are given. Let's see the solution and check which of these are correct. Statement 1 is correct. Windows Azure, now known as Microsoft Azure, is a cloud computing service created by Microsoft for building, testing, deploying, and managing applications and services through Microsoft managed data centers. Statement 2 is incorrect. Google App Engine is a platform as a service and cloud computing platform for developing and hosting web applications in Google managed data centers. Statement 3 is correct. Amazon Web Service is a platform that offers flexible, reliable, scalable, easy to use and cost effective cloud computing solutions. In our next question, two concurrent executing transactions T1 and T2 are allowed to update same stock items, say A, in an uncontrolled manner. In such scenario, following problems may occur. Now we have been asked which problems can occur. The following problems can occur when two or more concurrent transactions execute in an uncontrolled manner. Number 1, dirty read problem. It occurs when transaction is permitted to read data that is being modified by another transaction which is running concurrently but which has not yet committed itself. Unrepeatable read problem. This problem occurs when a transaction gets to read unrepeated, that is different values of the same variable in its different read operations, even when it has not updated its value. The third is phantom read problem. It occurs when in the course of transaction, two identical queries are executed and the collection of rows returned by the second query is different from the first. The fourth is lost update problem. It occurs when two different transactions try to update the same column on the same row within a database at the same time. Moving on to our next question, consider the following learning algorithms: logistic regression, backpropagation, and linear regression. Which of the following option represents classification algorithms? So let's see what are the types of classification algorithms in machine learning. Logistic regression. In this, the probabilities describing the possible outcomes of a single trial are modeled using a logistic function. Second is naive Bayes. It is based on Bayes' theorem with the assumption of independence between every pair of features. Stochastic gradient descent. It is a simple and very efficient approach to fit linear model. It supports different loss functions and penalties for classification. The fourth one is backpropagation. It performs learning on a multi-layer feed-forward neural network. The fifth is k-nearest neighbors. In this, classification is computed from a simple majority vote of the k-nearest neighbors of each point. In decision tree, given a data of attributes together with its classes, a decision tree produces a sequence of rules that can be used to classify the data. And the last is support vector machine. It is a representation of the training data as points in space separated into categories by a clear gap that is as wide as possible. In our next question, consider the following grammar. Which language does this grammar generate? So let's see the options. Option one is incorrect because every string generated by given grammar will contain only zeros and the given option is generating strings containing one also. Option two is also incorrect because it cannot generate string 000, whereas the given grammar in the question can generate string 000. We can see how it can be generated. S gives 0A, A gives double zero a and null, s gives triple zero a and a gives null, and putting the value of a as null, we get s is equal to triple zero. Option 3 is correct because it can generate string same as given grammar can generate. Option 4 is incorrect because the given option can generate string containing ones, whereas the given grammar can generate string containing only zeros. Moving on to our next question. The weight of minimum spanning tree in graph G calculated using Kruskal's algorithm is? We have been given a graph G and we have to calculate the weight of minimum spanning tree. So let's see the solution. Writing the weights of edges in ascending order, we get it 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, including 2 into the minimum spanning tree. It will be included in minimum spanning tree. Now 3, it will also be included in minimum spanning tree. Now 4, it will also be included. 5, it will not be included as it creates a cycle. And we don't have to include the edges, that creates a cycle. 6 will also be included. 7, it will not be included as it creates a cycle. And 8 will also be not included as it creates a cycle. So calculating the minimum distance 2 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3, so we get it as 15. Now in our next question, the reduced instruction set computer RISC characteristics are. Now let's see all the characteristics of the reduced instruction set computers. Simple instruction, hence simpler instruction decoding. Construction come under size of one word. Instruction takes single clock cycle to get executed. More number of general purpose registers. Simple addressing modes, less data types. Pipelining can be achieved. So these are the characteristics of the RISC computers. In our next question, let the population of chromosome in genetic algorithm is represented in terms of binary number. The strength of fitness of a chromosome in decimal form X is given by this function. The population is given by P, where P is, we have been given 4 pairs of binary numbers. So to calculate the strength, the population of chromosome in genetic algorithms is represented in terms of binary number. So we will take P, that is the population, X, the decimal representation of those binary numbers, and fx is equal to x square, the square of the decimal numbers. Now 0, 1, 0, 1 is 13 in decimal form and its square is 169. Similarly, we have written all the decimal numbers and all the squares. Now sfx is equal to fx divided by sigma fx. We have calculated sigma fx is equal to 1170. So strength of fitness of chromosome 1100 is f1100 divided by sigma fx, that is 576 divided by 1170. So it comes out as 0.492. Now multiplying it by 100, we get it as 49.2, and that is the answer. The strength of fitness of chromosome is multiplied by 100 because the raw fitness score returned by the fitness function needs to be converted to a range suitable for selection. In our next question, we have been given 4 statements and we have been asked which of the statements are true. So let's see the solution and check the correctness of each of the statements. The statement 1 is false. In fact, the running time of a dynamic programming algorithm is calculated as number of subproblems into time per subproblem. This would only be true if the time per subproblem is big O of 1. The statement 2 is correct. Cyclic dependency is a relation between two or more modules which either directly or indirectly dependent on each other. It has mutually recursive modules, so we cannot get a correct solution in dynamic programming. The statement 3 is false. Computing values using recursion and memorization is asymptomatically faster than computing values using dynamic programming algorithms in a bottom-up fashion. The statement 4 is false. If a problem X can be reduced to a known NP-hard problem, then X must be NP-complete. And in our last question, which of the following are legal statements in C programming language? We have been given 4 statements and we have been asked which of these are legal. So let's see the solution. Int sharpie is equal to ampersand 44,
is illegal because pointer variables holds address of a variable only. Int char p is equal to ampersand r is legal because of the above explanation. Int p is equal to ampersand a is illegal because only a pointer variable can hold the address of a given variable. And at last, int p is equal to a is legal because the values of a can be assigned to p. Hope you like our simplified approach. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.